Hola, pre-calc. Today we're going to talk about multiplying and dividing polar form. In order to multiply and divide polar form, we are going to consider two numbers. I will call them Z1 and Z2. We're going to represent Z1 by being A1 plus B1i. Okay, if A plus B1, or A plus BI, excuse me, is rectangular form, in polar form, that would be R1 times cosine theta 1 plus I sine theta 1. Alright, like I said, we're going to do the exact same thing with Z2. That would be A2 plus B2i, or R2 times cosine theta 2 plus I sine theta 2. And we are going to use Z1 and Z2 to show how we would multiply and divide in polar form. Let's talk multiplying. So, in order to do Z1 times Z2, we would need to do R1 times R2. Then we would take the cosine of theta 1 and add theta 2. And to finish off, we have plus I sine of theta 1 plus theta 2. You remember from class that cosine plus I sine can be simplified. So we can write this as R1 times R2 cis of theta 1 plus theta 2. And that right there is how we multiply in polar form. Example. Let's do 6 cis 75 degrees times 3 cis 15 degrees. All right, and I want you to express this in A plus BI form. That's what we're going for. So what we need to do, we're going to look at R1 times R2. Well, what's R1? That would be 6. What is R2? That's 3. Then we have cis theta 1, or 75 degrees, plus theta 2, which is 15 degrees. 6 times 3, 18. Cis 75 plus 15, that's 90 degrees. Okay, great. We've multiplied it in polar form, but remember, we want it to be in A plus BI form. So what we need to do is expand cis. That is 18 times cosine of 90 degrees plus I sine 90 degrees. And the cosine of 90 degrees is what? 0, correct. Plus I sine of 90 degrees is 1. So we distribute 18 times 0, 0, and we end up with a final answer of 18i. Not too bad, right? Let's go dividing. So when we divide, we are looking at Z1 divided by Z2. Well, remember multiplying, what did we do with the R's when we multiplied? We multiply the R's. So when we divide, we're going to divide the R's. We have R1 divided by R2 times the cosine of, what do you think we're going to do with the thetas? If you said subtract, you are exactly right. Theta 1 minus theta 2. It's still plus I sine. You don't change that. And we have theta 1 minus theta 2 again. If we put this in cis form, that would be R1 divided by R2 cis of theta 1 plus, I'm sorry, minus theta 2. All right, so that's dividing. Let's do an example. If you can hear my dog running around playing with her tennis ball, I'm really, really sorry. She is obnoxious. Okay. Same thing, we're going to do 6 cis 75 over 3 cis 15. Okay, Let's divide this. So we're going to take R1 divided by R2. Sis of theta 1 minus theta 2. All right. 6 divided by 3. Boom. 2. Sis. 75 minus 15. That's going to take us to 60 degrees. We're not done. We're going to take it all the way to A plus BI form. So we have to expand this. 2 times cosine of 60 degrees plus I sine 60 degrees. Unit circle, cosine of 60 degrees. 1/2. Plus I sine of 60 degrees. Root 3 over 2. Distribute that 2, and we get our final answer of 1 plus I root 3. Yes, if you wanted to write it as root 3i, that is totally acceptable, but you just got to make sure that the I does not go underneath the radical sign. That is wrong. Okay, so we knocked out 2 examples. I'm going to give you 3 that you should try. Whoa. All right, so let's do 3 you-dos. 1, I want you to multiply 2 cis 140 degrees times 5 cis 70 degrees. 2, I want you to divide 12 cis 85 degrees by 4 cis 40 degrees. And last but not least, number 3, I want you to take 3 cis 15 degrees and square it. Okay, pause the video, try these 3 problems, come back, check your answers. See you in a bit. And welcome back. Let's check our answers. So for number 1, if you said you're going to multiply 2 times 5 and get 10, and then take cis of 140 plus 70 and get 210 degrees, you were exactly correct. Then we would expand it 10 times cosine of 210 degrees, which is negative root 3 over 2, plus I sine 10 degrees. Oh my goodness. My pen is not cooperating. Okay, here we go. Try again. And we have I sine of 210 degrees. And the sine of 210 degrees is negative 1/2. And then we distribute the 10 and you should get negative 5 root 3 minus 5i. If you got that, high five, nice job. Let's come over here. 12 divided by 4, that should give you 3. Cis, 85 minus 40 is going to give you 45 degrees. Expand it. 3 times cosine of 45 degrees, 1 over root 2, plus I sine of 45 degrees, 1 over root 2. Distribute that 3. 3 over root 2 plus 3 over root 2i. You do not have to rationalize. If you want to, go for it. No big deal. Okay, number 3. You have to think, what does it mean to square something? Oh, multiply it by itself. So, 3 cis 15 times 3 cis 15. 3 times 3 is 9. 15 plus 15 is 30. So we get 9 cis 30. All right, that's 9 times cosine of 30 degrees, root 3 over 2, plus I sine of 30 degrees, 1/2. Distribute that 9, and we end up with 9 root 3 over 2 plus 9 over 2i. How'd you do? Hopefully you got all 3 great. I'm sorry, got all 3 right, and that would be great. All right, last thing I want to point out is I want you to notice that when we did 3 cis 15 and we squared it, and we got 9 cis 30. Is there a way I could rewrite 9 in terms of 3? And you're probably thinking it was 3 times 3, Ms. Gutierrez. That's how we got it. Oh, but that's also the same thing as 3 squared, right? Oh, and how did I get 30? Oh, well, we did 15 plus 15. Or I could have said 2 times 15. And so that actually plays an important part into what's happening. So when we have R cis theta squared, that was actually the exact same thing as R squared cis 2 theta. I wonder if that's the same thing for other exponents. That's something we'll be talking about when I see you again in class. Until then, have a great day, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.